Australia is racing to prepare Papua New Guinea for an influx of asylum seekers affected by the government's radical new policy. Plane loads of tents were sent to Manus Island today. The first group of asylum seekers is expected to follow within days. PNG's Prime Minister has confirmed it will permanently resettle refugees, but Australia will foot the bill.
Those who are originating out of Australia will be the responsibility of the Australian government.
Almost 1,500 asylum seekers have arrived since Kevin Rudd announced they would be sent straight to PNG. South Australian police have charged a 21-year-old man with trafficking a bad batch of ecstasy. 22 people were taken to hospital over the weekend. One remains in a critical condition. Police say those who took the drug had erratic behaviour.
A person licking the floor in a nightclub, people disrobing and rubbing themselves on the bitumen. They were obviously itchy. And a person acting like a chicken in the back of a taxi.
The pills are now being analysed. A number of Queensland streets have been locked down again after more explosives were found. For the third time in 4 days, detectives swooped on an Ipswich house after homemade devices were found in the kitchen and the bathroom.
For us is the callous disregard that these people have had in their handling of this material. This material is quite volatile.
It's the same house where a man was seriously injured in a blast on Thursday. A 43-year-old man has faced court on a number of drugs and explosive charges, but police say those involved are not connected to any terrorist activity. Hundreds more jobs have been lost after Pixie Photo was forced into administration. After 40 years, the photography company has shut, axing 300 jobs across the country. The opposition says it's the government's fault.
Why is it a surprise that people are losing jobs now? Because the fundamentals put in place by the Labor government make job creation very hard.
It had 42 outlets operating out of Kmart, Myer and Target. The company also had a school photo business, which it recently sold off. Wildlife experts are horrified by a shocking act of animal cruelty in Melbourne. A female kangaroo was found with two arrows piercing her body. And a warning, some may find images in this story disturbing. Melanie Davies reports.
After it was shot with two arrows, wildlife volunteers are doing all they can to save this eastern grey kangaroo. They had to tranquilise the injured animal before gently removing parts of the arrows.
It's another horrific act of cruelty we've seen out here in the east.
The distressed roo was spotted in bushland in Endeavour Hills yesterday morning. And this afternoon, after an extensive search, experts tracked her down. It's believed she recently had a joey, but released it from her pouch after she was shot.
Well, the joey would not survive without its mum, so it does need to be found. Unfortunately, it looks like it would be quite a young joey.
The kangaroo will now be taken to a nearby vet to undergo emergency surgery.
Hopefully it can be removed safely and we can rehabilitate the animal and release it. We just never know with these cases, though. They can just die from stress alone.
The arrows will be handed over to police. It's hoped fingerprints of the culprits will still be intact and can be used as evidence.
The consumer watchdog has raised serious concerns about petrol discounts offered by Coles and Woolworths. ACCC Chairman Rod Sims told a business lunch in Melbourne he's concerned that some discounts are reaching up to 45 cents a litre. He says that's likely to harm smaller retailers and competition. Results of its investigation into shopper dockets will be released in coming months. It's been revealed lawyers acting for Essendon's football coach have exchanged terse letters with the AFL. It comes as James Heard continues to stand his ground and new chairman Paul Little made his first public statement.
We look forward to James taking us into a successful finals campaign.
Former chairman David Evans stood down over the weekend after the Bombers lost to Hawthorn. The rugby league community is mourning one of its favourite sons, Graham Murray. The 58-year-old club and Origin coach lost his battle with heart disease in a Brisbane hospital after his wife and daughter made the difficult decision to turn off his life support. The much-loved mentor suffered a second heart attack this month. Now for a glimpse at life beneath one of the country's famous coastal landmarks. Scientists have explored the marine park surrounding the 12 Apostles in Victoria through special underwater cameras. After surveying hours of footage, marine biologists discovered hundreds of species of fish, shark and coral. Some parts resemble the Great Barrier Reef and there are no signs of invasive animals or seaweeds. A quick look at the weather across the country tonight. It's currently 22 degrees in Townsville, 14 degrees in Brisbane, 17 at the moment in Sydney, 13 in Melbourne, 14 degrees in Adelaide and 15 in Perth.